What do you charge, or how much does it cost to have a property manager manage my property? So first of all, let me start by saying that is a legitimate question. Okay, so I validate the importance of that question. But I want to tell you that that is a horrible first question to ask when you call a property management company. When you're shopping around, the worst thing that you can do is start the conversation by asking, how much do you charge? And let me give you an example of that. So there are many different ways to run a property management company, and there's many different services that are involved with managing a property. And some property management companies offer more of a white glove service, more of a full-featured set of tasks that they offer their clients. And others are more of a bare bones, let's just barely do the minimum, and we'll charge, you know, what's appropriate for that. So let me start by saying, I know that this rent rate is not a typical rent rate across the board, right? You're going to have some rent rates that are higher, you're going to have some that are lower. But let's just take the rent of $2,000 a month, and we're going to use some calculations on that. So for every 1% difference in a property management fee on $2,000 a month, it's about $20 a month. Okay, so for every 1% up or down, the difference is really $20 a month, which is really $240 a year. Okay, so what you should be asking is not how much do you charge, but what do you do and what do I get for the fees that I pay? And based on that, you can make a decision of, are the services that I want in line with what the property management company is offering? And so, again, to use that $2,000 a month or $240 swing on a 1% difference in property management fees, that $240 really equates to about just barely over 3.5 days worth of vacancy. Okay, so your daily rate, if your property sat vacant for an extra 3.5 days, that's going to equal about that $240 on a $2,000 a month rent rate. Okay, so using those calculations, you can say, well, if my property sits vacant with one property manager versus another, an extra 3.5 days, that's going to eat up the difference on that $2,000 a month rental and that 1%. It's going to eat up that difference for an entire year, right? So in the grand scheme of things, none of us want to pay more than we have to, right? We all want to get the best value. But there are different service offerings at different prices, specifically because people are looking for different levels of service. And that's not just in the property management industry, but that's in all industries across the board. So a better question to ask is not how much do you charge, but is the property management company service offerings in line with what I'm looking for? And then if it is it a good value? Am I getting what I want at a price that I'm willing to pay? Is it a good value? And so the better questions to ask are, what do you do to market my property? How do you handle maintenance? As an example, a botched maintenance request from a tenant, that can easily eat up that extra $240. If you hire a vendor that's not been screened or isn't a part of your approved vendor list, and they go out and they overcharge, well, it doesn't take long to have a maintenance item or two to have that eat that extra additional percentage that you're paying. And so really what you want to look at is, how do you handle maintenance? What do you do to market my property when it's vacant? What do you do for rent collections? How soon do I get my rent proceeds? So these are the questions you want to ask. And then once you've figured out that they're a good fit, now you can start talking about pricing and understanding what fees are associated with their services. Do they charge a monthly management fee? Do they charge a leasing fee? Do they charge a lease renewal fee? If they do, how much are those fees? And in addition, do they do quarterly inspections? If they do, is it included? Is it an extra fee? So while I totally understand that nobody wants to pay more than they feel they should on anything that they purchase, starting out with how much do you charge actually puts the property manager or the property management company that you're calling in charge of the conversation that you're having, because now they can craft their message around why they're the most expensive or why they're the cheapest. And really they're driving the conversation as opposed to finding out what the management company actually does to protect your asset. Now at Home Vault, we say that there's really only two things that you hire us for. First thing is you hire us to assist you with managing the risks associated with being an investment property owner. And the second thing that you hire us for is to assist you with maximizing the long-term returns associated with being an investment property owner. So in both cases, we really are there to secure your asset now and to secure your asset and your financial future in the future. And so everything that we do comes back to one of those two things. All the services that we offer really come back to those two points. So if you'd like more information about our services, feel free to reach out. I'm Tony Klein with Home Vault Property Management. You can get more information at homevault.com or check out our Facebook page or check out our YouTube channel. All right, thanks. Take care.